Hello everybody. For this class, we are going to use two GBC soldering stations. One is for precision and the other one is for power. The work that we'll present can be done with any soldering station, no matter the brand, only the technique matters. This is the first class of our microsoldering training course. For a clean and professional job, we are going to use a quality flux. After 10 years of experience, we have chosen two brands of flux, the Cheap Quick and the Amtage. They are two flux of tremendous quality. To desolder any SMD component, in the first step we have to apply flux. We are going to desolder the smallest component that exists in a mobile motherboard. For this process, we use a GBC soldering station at 350 Celsius degrees and 50% air. We also use a precision anti-static clamp. Now we are going to desolder an SMD resistor for a laptop motherboard. The first trick that I'll share with you is that you always have to find the perfect position of the motherboard so you can remove the component easily. If we are dealing with small components, a small nozzle must be used as in this case. This is a low component, a resistance, because like you see, it has a white stripe on the side. If you have a heating station that maintains the airflow very well, then you can remove the component without applying flux. We will see below that there is not such a difference between these two techniques. This is an oversized SMD inductor on a mobile motherboard. During this training course, many times we'll work with 350 Celsius degrees of temperature and 50% air. We are going to apply Amtage flux to the component next to it and the same temperature and airflow. If you have the ability to apply air outward from the motherboard, it's perfect because in this way the surrounding components will suffer less. Here it can be seen that there is not such difference in removing one and the other component. Remember, position the motherboard well so you can remove the component easily. On the description of this video, I leave you the link with the tools and the soldering supplies that we use. We apply a little flux and with the help of air station, we remove the capacitor. The best technique is to bring perpendicularly the nozzle closer to the component. When the lead solder changes color and becomes shiny is the moment when it goes from a solid to a liquid state, and this is the time to remove the component. Sound easy, right? Let's see how it works with a component of a larger size. In this case, we raise the temperature to 380 Celsius degrees and 50% air. On some occasion, if we have the need to remove two components from the same area, we can take advantage of a hot motherboard, and in this way we can remove it easier. Let's check on a laptop motherboard with a fairly large component. Remember that the computer motherboards dissipate heat very well, so on many occasions you have to raise the temperature and the airflow. We are going to solder the tracks with low temperature paste solder and use a desoldering mesh to remove it. We use the same temperature, 350 Celsius degrees and 50% air. You can see that the component is very resistant, and the same situation will happen to you if you don't have much experience. A mobile motherboard is not the same as a computer motherboard. The last one dissipates heat very well and is much thicker. This is the reason why the component does not come out. If after 30 seconds the component does not loosen, then the temperature and the airflow must be increased. Ideally, when we work on this kind of motherboards, is to use a preheater below the motherboard. Never do these movements. The component has to come out easy when the solder lid becomes liquid. During this training course, where we are going to advise you not to make these mistakes when you are working with integrated circuits or SMD components, it is better to stop the process and raise the temperature with 20 Celsius degrees and 10% air. We continue with the process until the component is easily removed. Below this component, we can see two fairly large solder tracks. Without applying a lot of temperature, we cannot melt this solder lid from below, so we'll never be able to remove this component. We continue with a laptop motherboard with an 8 pads component. We apply flux, and with the help of a heating station, we use 350 Celsius degrees and 50% air. Very easy, right? To desolder any component, we follow the same steps. We apply a little flux, we set the temperature and airflow correctly depending on the size of the component, and that's it. There are not so many tricks. If the component is a larger size, we'll need more time. And if the component is small, we remove it earlier. And don't forget the size of the nozzle. For a larger component, a large nozzle, and for a smaller component, a small nozzle. We continue with this motherboard mobile to see how easily the SMD components can be removed. Here we can find small and medium-sized components. Here we have a charging connector from a Samsung device. To desolder it, we use the same technique. We apply a little flux, 350 Celsius degrees and 50% air. We don't have to apply pressure to extract it in any moment. When the solder lid melts, the charging connector comes out on its own. Guys, this has been today's class. I'll just ask you to practice at home or in your lab using broken motherboards. This is the best way to continue advancing in the world of the microsoldering. Thanks for watching, and if you like it, please share it, and see you soon.